Hey folks, my name's Todd Mansfield. I'm a clinical herbalist here in Byron Bay, Australia, and today we're talking about gut motility and small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, or SIBO. So SIBO, it's a condition that I treat frequently here in the clinic, and I'm always questioning and I'm always working towards determining and treating the root cause. You know, why has your body allowed bacteria to overgrow where it shouldn't? I find that motility is a major, major root cause, and there are four common causes of motility disturbances or dysregulations in the digestive tract. Number one, we've got inflammation. So with SIBO, there tends to be this shift towards this kind of pro-inflammatory microbiome in the small bowel. There's a shift towards this family of bugs called Enterobacteriaceae, big fancy weird name, but really the kind of headline of this family is inflammation, right? And a little bit of Enterobacteriaceae in the gut is fine, it's normal, it's healthy, it's probably beneficial, but an excessive amount can lead to this inflammatory cascade that can actually slow down your gut transit. That slowing down of the gut transit can lead to this bloom or this buildup in the small bowel of SIBO, and then you wind up with this vicious cycle of inflammation, slowing down the gut, leading to a buildup, leading to more inflammation. Number two, an excessive amount of methane production in the gut, slowing down gut motility. You know, excessive methane production, methane SIBO, methane LEMO, large intestinal methane overgrowth, is a condition that I commonly treat. It's a very stubborn bug in some patients. Methane is a gas produced by archaea bugs. So they're not even really bacteria. You know, the most common one is Methanobrevibacter smithii. There's a number of other bugs that produce methane. But the key aspect to methane production is that it slows down that smooth muscular contractions that propels food down the digestive tract and out, right? So excessive methane gas slows down your gut motility, leading to more methane gas production. That little bug likes slow motility. So intervening, again, we want to speed up the motility that can bring down the gas levels and get on top of that bug. Number three, we've got chronic stress. And you probably heard so much about chronic stress. Chronic stress can lead to poor gut motility. And the big point here is that the nervous system and the nerves that innervate a lot of our digestive tract, you know, particularly the vagal nerve, it functions optimally in that rest and digest side of the nervous system, right? That parasympathetic side. So rest and digest, right? We're calm, we're eating, we're digesting our food, we're breaking it down, we're absorbing nutrients. So chronic stress, something that needs to be addressed if that's you and you have SIBO. Number four, food poisoning leading to SIBO through this gut motility axis. The science is a little bit complex and we're still teasing it out, so you can check the link below the video for more info. But the long and short is that these food poisoning bacteria, they tend to secrete this toxin called cytolethal distending toxin. Salmonella, Shigella, E. coli, Campylobacter, there's a handful of other ones. And there's this immune dysregulation in some patients, you know, not everyone, thankfully, where there's this kind of misfiring leading to motility dysregulation, poor motility. So here, it's important to address that. It's a blood test that you can do. It's expensive. I have never run it before. It might be something that I do in the future, but I'm always screening for and addressing this post-infectious presentation. So there you have it. Those are four common causes of gut motility disturbances that can lead to SIBO in patients. There's also things like pelvic adhesions, which should be on your radar. I don't commonly see it, but it's something that I'm aware of and I'm not ignoring. You know, if you found this video helpful, you got something out of it, then click the like button below, leave me a comment. And if you are looking for gut support and you live in Australia or New Zealand, then consider working with us here at Byron Herbalist. Thanks for watching.